Hi guys, welcome to PM Coding Tutorials. In today's video, I will show you how to create this loading animation. So, let's begin. I have my project open in VS Code with some basic HTML that has the style sheet linked. The CSS file itself is completely empty. To the HTML file, I am adding a div with the class container. Inside, I am nesting three other divs, each with a class of ball. If you are using the same editor, you can use the abbreviation to create them quicker. That's all the HTML we need. On to the CSS. First, I am defining a CSS variable in the root for the blue color so I don't have to type out its hex value all the time. Then I am resetting all the styles with the universal selector and applying a padding and margin of 0. To the body, I am assigning a background of black so that the background is dark and the light blue of the dots stands out more. Next, I am styling the container. I am giving it a width of 100%. I want to center the nested divs, and for this I am using text-align center. I also want to center them horizontally, so I am giving the container the position of absolute to remove it from the normal document flow. Then I am moving it 50% away from the top. Finally, I am using transform, translate y minus 50% to center it perfectly. For the ball class, I am adding a background of the main color. I want it to be 2 ramps wide and high. To make it round, I am giving it a border radius of 50%. There should be space between each of them, which I can achieve with a margin of 0, 2.5 rem. This way, the margin at the top and bottom will be 0, but on the sides it will be 2.5 rems. And finally, I am making them inline block. Divs are by default block, but by making them inline block, I can have them move next to each other. Let's see how the project looks now. I am starting Live Server, which is a VS Code extension, and will reload the project anytime I save changes. Okay, so here we have three balls next to each other. We can do the CSS animation next. When animating the balls, I want to move them up from their current position. To be able to do this, I have to give them the position relative. To define the animation, we need to declare it with the @keyframes keyword. Then you can state its name. In this case, I will call it bounce. At the beginning of the animation, so at 0%, I want them to be where they are now. With bottom 0, I am saying it should be 0% away from the bottom of its current position. At 50%, I want it to move up, so I am adding a bottom of 4 rem. Finally, at the end of the animation, I again want it to be at its original position, so I am adding bottom 0. With this done, let's assign the animation to the balls. I can use the animation shorthand by saying animation, then the name, which is bounce, the time frame of 1 second, the timing function, which is linear, and the iteration count, which should be infinitive, so it plays non-stop. If we look at the changes, we can see that the balls are moving up and down. In the final animation, you can however see they also get squashed, so I want to add this effect next. For this, we can use transform scale. Scale takes two values. With the first one, I can change the width, and with the second one, I can do the height. At the start, I want it to be squashed from the impact of the fall, so I am increasing its width by 20%. 1 stands for 100% of its original width. By adding 0.2, I am basically saying add 20% to its width. 1.2 equals 120%. The height I am decreasing by 10%, so I am adding 0.9 as the second argument. At 50%, when the ball is bouncing back, I want the height to be bigger and the width narrower, so I am giving it a transform scale of 0.9 and 1.1. At 100%, it should be like it is at the beginning. Let's look at the changes. Now the balls get squashed upon impact and the animation looks more realistic. The last thing we need to do is add a delay to the second and third ball. We can do this by using the env selector. Here I am selecting the second one and assigning an animation delay of 0.3 seconds. To the third one, I am assigning a delay of 0.6. Now each of them animates after each other. I am not quite happy with the way it looks, so I will alter the duration to 0.8 seconds and the delays to 0.2 and 0.4 seconds. Here is the final project. If you want, you can also add some background color animation to make it more interesting. I have, for example, also made a 3D neon version like this. I have also linked this below if you want to check out its code. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe for more tutorials like this. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Have a lovely day and see you next time.